Now, I want to transition to a powerful example of an integrated design flow that shows how quickly you can move from the simulation of a system to full-on implementation. Now, we know that a lot of folks are already using LabVIEW to build robotic systems, ranging from autonomous vehicles to humanoid robots. One of the main hiccups in the design flow for a traditional methodology is when you're moving out of the simulation space and on into full-on implementation. And so I'm proud to say with the robotics module that we're releasing in 2012, we've included a feature called the Robotics Simulator. And what it allows you to do is quickly import from a CAD package like SolidWorks, where you might mechanically model your robot. You can pull that over into a simulator where in LabVIEW, you can quickly tune your control algorithm without having to fabricate the robot. Andy, can you give us an example of the design flow there?
Sure. So as an example, let's go ahead and take a look at the U-Bot from KUKA Laboratories. It is actually a very sophisticated mobile manipulation platform that bridges the gap between teaching, research, and industrial applications. So what we've done is we actually incorporated a CAD model into LabVIEW using the LabVIEW robotic simulators, and we imported it, and we built a simulation environment within LabVIEW. And so you can see, now here's a simulated U-Bot within LabVIEW. So Eric, why don't you go ahead and take that iPad behind you and try to drive the simulated robot within this environment. So what we've done is we actually incorporated web services on the iPad to talk to the main application running on the host machine. And as Eric is demonstrating, he has full control of both the kinematics and dynamics of the KUKA U-Bot. And just for you guys, we actually built a customized stage for NI Week this year to welcome you all.
Look, look, Dave, there we are,
yeah.
Two women.
I think they had a off by one error on the genders. So this is a great example of leveraging standard technology. We have a custom iPad app written where we're looking at the gyros on the iPad, and we're kind of just taking the XY values of the robot, bundling those up, and sending them over the standard HTTP call back to a computer that's just sitting in a loop that has a VI waiting for that web service call. Kind of just unbundle those parameters, pass it on to the visual simulator, and then the location of the robot updates on the screen.
Now, Andy, Dave mentioned that one of the challenges in this design flow is going from simulation to real-world implementation. So how do the new tools help with that?
Yeah, so within the LabVIEW robotics module, we introduce what's called a hardware abstracted I/O technology that allows the users to deploy their code into the real system. And what they will have to do is, instead of using it in a simulation environment, they will go ahead and deploy the same algorithm into the real-time target. So Eric, why don't you go ahead and try to tilt the iPad? I hear a little sound behind me. And as you can see, we now are deploying the same algorithm on the real-time processor on NI Compact Rio. And Eric, again, has full control of both the kinematics and dynamics of the KUKA U-Bot. And we were able to reuse the same code from simulation to real-world implementation.
Thanks for the demo, Andy.
That's cool.
Now, what we've shown you now just kind of scratches the surface of the power and capability of what we released with LabVIEW 2012. I encourage you to take a look at those templates and sample projects and maybe learn more about how the LabVIEW Rio architecture powers the most powerful instruments on the earth.
Thanks, guys. Very cool.